thanks for being here. This is very nice. Music Factory is an incredible place, and my book came out on Halloween, and 20 years in the making, and really the big goal was to get here and to do this gig, and this is sort of the end of the tour for now, at least for 2015, and it was really meaningful to me that C.C. and Zachary want to come down and play some tunes for you guys, so of course that's the big part of it. I'm not going to do any big book reading or anything, but we do have copies of the book. I actually brought in some limited edition hardcovers. We printed 350 of these. They're really nice. We call them the Gold Crown Edition, and we have some up there. I think we have about 20 left, and so if you want to check those out, those are kind of cool, and of course I'd be thrilled to sign them for you. One of the fun things about the book is that it's the first book about the King of Zydeco, and in 1995 I started working on it and thought I would be finished pretty, you know, a couple years maybe at the most, and that wasn't the case, and that was because he's a really big figure, and he didn't leave much of a trail beyond his records. He was a man on the move, and he went all over the place, and anywhere you travel on this planet, you call his name or you say the word Zydeco, and it's kind of all one big awareness of South Louisiana, thanks to him. And so in working on the book, though, I realized that it would make a lot of sense to wrap his story in stories of living musicians working, inspired by, directly and indirectly connected to him. And so the book has a bunch of chapters in it. It has a chapter on the Little Band of Gold, Zachary Richard, Little Buck Senegal, Beau Soleil, Buckwheat Zydeco, Philae, Bonsoir Catin, Roddy Romero and the Hub City All-Stars, Steve Riley and the Mamou Playboys, and I think just a few others. And the first artist to perform today is sort of the MVP. He doesn't have a chapter under his own name, but he crops
up. I've got the same initials as Clifton Chenier, so that's my claim to fame.
Or Cleveland Chenier.
Yeah.
So it's kind of a nice little triumvirate.
I think my parents actually named me after Cleveland and then later found out about Clifton. They were that hip.
And if you've known this guy a long time, you know that some people call him Charles. But yeah, his middle name is Cleveland. So C.C. Adcock right here, folks. Or Clifton, something like that.
Clinton. Yeah.
And yeah, so all of a sudden, C.C. is in the chapter on Philae, working with those guys. He's, of course, leader of Little Band of Gold with all those other great guys. He's in that chapter.
Don't blame me.
He's produced records with Steve Riley and the Mamou Playboys and Zachary Richard. And so it's kind of neat how all those interconnections exist. Obviously, that's what this is all built on. That's why we're all here. That's how our culture works, is that we're all in this together. And y'all's support really means a lot, and want to thank C.C. for coming out to play some tunes for y'all from the book and inside and outside of those pages and tell some stories, and thank you again. How about a big hand, C.C. Adcock?
All right. Todd and I grew up together, literally since we were children, went to school together. His family was like, his mom and dad were like my mother and father, and vice versa. I know Miss Janice is here. And I have to say, it's not shameless, not just because he's my buddy, the book's really great. I promise you I've read at least the chapter on me. Me. I looked up where all the parts where my name was, make sure you got the story right. And Todd and I, no, it's a great book, and he's put in the work on Clifton, and I think anybody, I mean, now I think it's more so just anybody who's into good stuff, but certainly anybody that's from Louisiana. It used to be anybody who lived in Lafayette, Southwest Louisiana, was Clifton, you know, everyone was inspired by or worked with or knew a story about Clifton. He was just the guy. There's never been anybody greater. I know Zachary has written a lot about him and in his songs and in the grooves, and I never got to see Clifton, but I'm glad that this book's out, and the DVD that you can get with it is just some live Clifton at Jay's Cockpit and at the Kingfish in Baton Rouge where Slim Harpo and everybody used to play, and it's just fantastic to be able to sit there and just watch a Clifton Chenier gig. It's not some documentary with people giving interviews and Bono isn't giving you his ideas on, you know, Clifton Chenier. It's just Clifton Chenier playing a gig, so it's really cool. So I play a song that ties back to the book. There was a great, back in the early 90s, this Djamma Garnier, the great Creole fiddle player from Lafayette, played in Philae, a bunch of other bands now, a bunch of Zydeco bands. He came across this great sort of African poem, Creole poem. You know, back in the old days, olden days, once again, I let Zachary give the history lesson because he knows it backwards and forwards. And he was there. But I'm just younger, a little bit younger. Now, back in the old days, the Mississippi River was sort of the, you know, West Coast, and after that was just uncharted territory. That's what they had the Baton Rouge. If you went past the red stick, you were out of federal jurisdiction. You were just kind of on your own. So still sort of kind of like that. When you get to Lake Charles, at least. So Djamma found this great sort of Creole poem about a runaway slave, someone who had kind of gone out to that part of the world. He got on the other side of the Mississippi River to sort of make his own way, running through the mush and, you know, marsh and swamps. And anyway, Djamma and I turned it into a little rock and roll song, so I'll play it for you now. I'll sing the English bit, because my French ain't that good. I'll leave that to Zachary as well. Okay, yeah, sure, the governor. We have any Band of Gold fans in the house tonight?
Yeah!
No.
Me too. I wish we were playing David, our brother David Egan's. He's fighting for it back at home, he's a little sick, but we're gonna spend Christmas together, so that'll be good. And the rest of the boys all said to say hello, except for Dickie Landry. And Jesus, he told him, go to hell. He's always a little bit grumpy, dude. There's a song I wrote with my cousin about, it's about Edwin Edwards. And when I was a kid and had my big break in the record business, and this guy called Denny Cardell came down and signed me to a big record deal, he became this sort of mentor for me, and he used to give me lots of advice and produce records and help me figure out how to do this stuff. And he died, you know, in the mid-90s, just about the time the record business died, my career died. Anyway, so Denny on his deathbed called me from Ireland, sort of said goodbye, and he gave me this advice. And this is a guy who had sort of found Bob Marley and Joe Cocker and Tom Petty, and I was in good company from J.J. Cale. And Denny said, he had an Irish accent, but he said, you know, I can't do an Irish accent, but he said, Charlie, whatever you do, just don't write about politics. I said, just write about the stuff you know, girls and pork chops and cars and, you know, and guitars and stuff. But don't write about politics, that just ain't your thing. So when I wrote this song about Edwin Edwards, I realized, damn, I'm writing about politics. But it was Edwin Edwards, so it's still sort of about girls and pork chops. A little song called Last Hayride. Thanks for asking for it.
Dream states, license plates are stamped out by Angola inmates. It takes a big man not to be little. Sun's coming up on your quill. Chicken in every pot, every man a king. So kiss a nut on the list for me like you told old vigilante shit. Hey baby, we both good underneath the sheets. Growing and the good times rolling, just call me little Napoleon. And when there's no money left to steal, no wall left to grease that wheel, kind of like Bretton. We will lie, Lisa, tell y'all I am sure. And trust me, I believe in Louisiana. Tapping down sorority row. Yeah, back at the mansion they was tapping the phones of the feds and dying. You trust me, baby, you just did your job right. A silver fox with a golden tongue. You played smart when you kept us dumb. Lord, you really kept them dumb. Yeah, you really kept us dumb. Now you got bones buried everywhere and bars across your view. Ignorant children picking cotton down here, still ain't ever caught no glimpse of you. Even if you walked on water, yeah, all the last say ride that soul.
Sorry for that.